Okay, today I want to talk about radio interference in a home solar power system. Here's my equipment for off-grid, a trace inverter. And here we have the solar charge regulators, which are a source of radio interference. There's three of them. We're going to do something about that. For demonstration, I have a single generator set to 16 megahertz. I have a shortwave radio set to 16 megahertz. And if you hear, the signal from the single generator is masked by noise, and the noise is from the solar power system. We also have set up a spectrum analyzer, and I determined previously that the little pulse jumping up and down on the left is the interference from the solar charge regulators, the maximum power point regulators. And here is a two-turn loop of wire connected to a coax line, which is feeding the input to the spectrum analyzer. So we're picking up from that little electromagnetic pickup loop. And we're going to get into the details later, but I'm going to attempt to show the reduction of that interference when I connect bypass capacitor. See that little pulse disappear now? And now we go back to the radio. And you hear the interference has gone away. And the tone from the signal generator, 400 hertz tone, is coming through clear. Although I have the volume turned down quite a bit. So I'm going to show you what I did. Mechanically, the two ceramic capacitors connected across the output of one of the regulators. So we still have interference from the other two, but we've cut it in half. And there's a little white wire touching the ground plane in the back, a sheet of aluminum. The theory of this is simply this. Anytime we have a noisy device with output wires, and in this case input wires, the input is from the solar panel and the output goes to a battery bank and the solar inverter. Typically you have a pair of wires. In any noisy device, an input and output pair. In this case, the output is a red and black wire feeding over to the battery bank, right? One is plus, one is minus. It normally puts out 12 to 16 volts for battery charging. Now the power being transferred, it's called differential mode. One is plus and one is minus. If I clamp my loop around the two wires, the pair of wires feeding the battery bank or the another device in this diagram, I'll read a net zero, kind of a balanced line. We call that the differential mode. Now the common mode is the noise that is equally on both wires, both on the input and the output in this case. So what I'm saying is that this becomes an antenna. The noise generator is feeding a dipole antenna. The output pair is one half of a dipole. The input pair is the other half of a dipole. And I'm saying the proper fix would not be to ground the device necessarily, and certainly not to ground either the input or the output. You'll change it from a half-wave dipole to a quarter-wave radiator. It'll still radiate. Furthermore, if you try putting in inductive filters in this frequency range, it's not nearly as effective. We're talking about a 16 megahertz frequency that has harmonics clear up into the broadcast FM and television band. We need to use capacitors. So here's a diagram of what I've done. The noise generator, in this case, is the charge regulator. You need two capacitors, not one. And the better balanced they are, the better it's going to work. So two capacitors connected to the closest you can find to a ground plane in the noise generator, in this case the heatsink of the device. If you use a single capacitor across the two terminals, it won't do the job. It will just make it work even better as a noise generator. You need a balanced pair of capacitors, and the closer they are together in value, the better it's going to work. Now, to finish my job, I would have a pair of capacitors on the input, and I would do all of the other devices in the system. Hope this is useful. Bye-bye.